our comfort zone in the television audience, but this is just the way it is, and if you don't get it, it certainly won't be my fault, because I'm going to teach it until God takes me out of here. Praise the Lord. So we need to get this straight, that this is the first commandment, and that we should love the Lord our God with all of our heart. Remember now, when the scripture speaks of the heart, it has reference to this. It has to do with the realm of our mental activity. For Solomon said, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. So you think not with this organ, you think with this one. So medical scientists, cardiologists, when they speak in terms of the heart, they're speaking of this organ. And when neurologists speak in terms of the mind, they speak of this organ. But when the Bible speaks in terms of the heart, it's speaking of this. And when it speaks in terms of the mind, it's speaking of this. Praise the Lord. And so we're to love him with all of our heart. Then there is no room in our mind for anything other than God. And I heard Jesus say, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Praise the Lord. And what kind of mind was that? A mind of humility. The Bible said that being in the form of God, he thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even unto the death of what? The cross. So it was a mind of humility. Praise the Lord. And so this is what we ought to do. We ought to love him. And this term love here is agape. It has to do with loving him with a godly love. It is the highest form of love that you possibly could love with. It is the love of God for God shed abroad in our hearts by the what? Holy Ghost. You remember the 5th chapter of Romans said the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost. So the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts when we allow the life of Christ to be demonstrated through what we do in our communication and all manner of living. When we are obedient to the word of God, it proves that we have the mind of God and that we love him. Praise the Lord. You didn't know that? Turn to somebody and say, didn't you know that? And so obedience proves love. Now people have this strange revelation, or should I say revolution, on love. They think love is what they come up with. It's passion. It's holding hands in public. Nonsense. The devil can hold your hand in public and then kill you behind closed doors. And I have many people smooch in public and fight behind closed doors. That means absolutely nothing in and of itself. Praise the Lord. But love is proving by our service, by our obedience. If we love our wives, we will serve and take care of them, and we will be the savior of their body. We will see to it that they have all the things they need. And we will always give consideration to them if we are married in making certain that we are fulfilling our God-given responsibilities to them. If we love our children, the same. If we love our husbands, the same. And if we are single, we are certainly unhindered by the imperfections in people today that claim they love God and treat their wives and husbands like dogs. Praise the Lord. And so the point in case is then if we love him with all of our heart, then that means we have his mind and we will be obedient in our thinking. And we never have to worry about being a gossiper, a backbiter, a liar, cheat, theft, a homosexual, a lesbian, an adulterer, an adulteress, whatever have you. Because we love him. He said, if you love me, you will keep my words. Amen. Then, of course, now with all thy soul, now you know what the soul is. The soul is what we are. It is the seat of the affections, emotions, and the will of man. It is what we are. We are a soul. It is the eternal part of us. It is the part of us that is saved. Because remember now, we are a trichotomy of body, soul, and spirit. Look at me now. If you look up here, do you see me? You most certainly do not. You only see the house that my soul lives in. Inside of this body is a soul. That is what I am. When I die, my body will go back to the dust from whence it came. The spirit of life is the life of the body. The spirit of life, when I die, is taken out of the body. The scripture says the body without the spirit is dead. So when God takes the spirit of life out of the body dies and goes back to the dust from whence it came, and the soul rests in the grave until either the first resurrection, which is the rapture of the church, or the second resurrection. Praise the Lord. Now then, we should recognize then that when we are saved, our spirits or our lives of this body are born again. And that has to do with not only the life of us communicating, living, going, and coming, but all of that basically is conducted by our mental what? Disposition. What we are mentally disposed to think and do. So when we're born again, our spirits, our lives, or our mental disposition is born again. And we take on the mind of who? I didn't hear you. And then our bodies can't go to heaven because flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. So our bodies are temporarily adopted into the family of God until such time as the rapture of the church takes place and we put off these bodies and we put on our new houses or bodies, which are from where? Heaven. Praise the Lord. So when the rapture takes place, we will shed these bodies and we'll put on our new bodies. Our souls will be clothed upon with a new body. Praise the Lord. So our bodies are temporarily adopted into the family of God until the rapture takes place, or if we die, until the resurrection of the dead takes place. Our spirits are born again, which is the life of these bodies. Our soul is saved. And that's what he came to save. He didn't come to save my body. He came to save my soul. My body's adopted. My spirit is born again. My soul is saved. And this is strictly according to the Holy Scriptures and the Word of God. So we are to love the Lord with all of our heart. Well, if we love the Lord with all of our heart or our mind, then we will give that to him and our bodies will be kept under control by the baptism of what? The Holy Ghost. If we love him with all of our souls will be what? Saved and preserved. Then it says, and with all thy what? And with all thy mind, and that is again this up here, praise the Lord, it is with all of our thinking. All of our mind means with all of our thinking. All of our heart has to do with all of our thoughts. Now, of course, you may understand this. Mind and heart in the scripture, for the most part, are one and the same. But when it talks about our heart, it's talking about this. When it talks about our mind, it's talking about this. So it has to do with our thoughts and our thinking. And he knows our thoughts before we what? Think them. Can we say amen? So with all of our mind, read, and with all thy strength. Now, that then means we need to give our strength to the Lord. Now, many times what we do is we give our strength to our jobs. We work for 9, 10, 11, 12 hours a day. There's nothing wrong with that if you pace yourself to do so, as long as at the end of the day you are not so tired that you can't come to Bible class. You can't come to prayer. You cannot come to the house of the Lord where you need to come to receive what you need for your soul. So all of our strength, we should make certain that our strength is saved to keep the commandment of who? God. And the scripture talks about young men not giving their strength to a strange woman. Because after she takes your strength, then she'll take your money. Or if it's a strange man, after he takes your strength and he leaves you with a child out of wedlock or children and leaves you with the purse with no money in it to take care of anything. Amen. But if you give your strength to the Lord, and I wish I had time to deal with this, because John said he calls you young man. I have written unto you young men because you are strong. And inasmuch as we're strong, there is a strength in youth that is not in individuals as they get older. You lose your strength as you get older. That's just the way that life is. Praise the Lord. And so much of what you see here, if the Lord tarry and I live long, this will become, if all things being equal, this side of town has been developed and is being developed. Lord tarry, and his will continue to be done as we trust that it will, this will be a multi-million dollar complex. And it will continue to grow, and it will continue to be developed. Now, why is that? It's not because we have 1,000 members, because we don't have 1,000 members. It isn't because we have any millionaires in the church, because I'm not a millionaire yet. Can we say amen? But it is because of the strength that has been given to God to use and that has been yielded to him in his love and obedience to him, that his will might be what? Done. Praise the Lord. And I can assure you it will continue to be a marvel if the Lord tarry to not only this community but those who come and go. Now, God is without respect to persons, and he is blessing his people everywhere. But we are to love him with all of our what? Strength. Now, I could take my strength and give it to other things if I so chose to do so. It would not benefit me anything, because I would wind up in trouble with God, losing everything that God has given me, and no doubt on my way to the lake that burneth with fire and brimstone. Praise the Lord. But this is what is the first commandment. With all thy strength. What is this? This is what? The first commandment. All right. Volume, please. There's 31. I shouldn't have to keep saying it. Verse 31. And the second is like, namely this. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. Now remember, John said, if you cannot love your brother whom you have seen, how can you say you love God whom you have not seen? And so if you cannot keep number two, the second commandment, you'll never be able to keep number one, which is, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. You can't keep that if you can't keep number two. Can we say amen? Now then, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is what? The Lord our God is what? What is he? Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and verse number 2 and 3. Now, if you are truly one of the spiritual children of Israel, because we are spiritual Israel, that's what we are. Now that we're born again of water and spirit, we're spiritual Israel. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 2 and 3. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. If you have it, everyone that loves the Lord should be reading the scripture. Let's read. Ye know that ye were Gentiles, carried away unto these dumb idols, even as ye were led.